You know, people always ask me why I live in the Pacific Northwest. They complain that it's rainy and it's wet and it's overcast all the time. But look, the sun is out, it's gorgeous. You can see Mount Rainier in the distance. This is why I live in the Pacific Northwest. Look at that view. Hello, Vashon, my old friend. Well, we're here, our first evening. It's Memorial Day weekend. We're in our cute little cottage. It's a little old, but it's still nice. I'm going to show you what it means to do things Vashon style. Good morning, America. So here we are, first morning of Memorial Day weekend. And last night we slept on what might be the world's hardest mattress. Oh! Though to be honest, I prefer that over one of those mattresses that break your back because you just fall into it, it's so soft. We brought our own espresso machine, so we got to have coffee just the way we like it, strong enough to give you whiplash. Now we're just sitting out here, looking out over the beautiful waters of the Puget Sound. We can see the Cascade Mountains in the background, and jutting up from that beautiful skyline, Mount Rainier. I think I'm just gonna settle in and enjoy the view for a while. I'm standing here in front of the Vashon hardware store. There's a lot of history in this building. It's a restaurant now, and we just had a fantastic meal. But being here brings back memories for me. I must have been in my late teens when I started coming here. My friend Mark Hoshi's family owned a family farm not too far from here, probably about a mile from where I'm standing right now. They had greenhouses where they grew vegetables and flowers, and they'd been doing so for over 100 years. When I started coming here back in the 80s, it was just Mark and his uncle left. And I remember spending a lot of time in this building right behind me, the hardware store, which was actually still a hardware store at that time. Now picture the old-fashioned hardware store with the wood floors, and still has wood floors today, but they've been refinished. The orderly aisles, bins filled with nuts and bolts, and all sorts of tools. Along the walls were hung all sorts of iron tools, because this was a farming community back then. And at the time, things were changing. This was the last gasp of the farming community, and things weren't looking good economically, and sure enough, the hardware store went out of business. Until it came back into business. It kept the name, but it turned into an upscale restaurant. They serve really good food and drinks here now. But it's great that they've kept the architecture, the building, and the history, and it's nice to see that history alive today. Brings back memories for sure. Welcome to the famous Little Red Bike in the Tree. Years ago, a little red bike was left standing next to a tree here in the woods. Now this happened over half a century ago. Over time, the tree grew up and around the bike, basically swallowing it whole. As the tree continued to grow up, the bike went with it. Billy saying, "Oh, hey, yeah, I used to live here. I lived here for 21 years, and then 10 years ago I moved to Tacoma. We're just back for the weekend to have some fun. Wait, what's that, Jennifer? Oh, yeah, I'll lower my mask so you can see my face, too." And he's saying, "I know just enough, ASL, but I need you to slow down a little." "Yeah, hi, my name is Dash." Billy saying, "Hey, I'm Billy, and this is Jennifer." I'm here at Camp Colvos Brewing. I'm having the meat pie, and it's oh good. "Mama, I tried. For 2 months, I stayed on the keto diet. I stayed away from flour. I stayed away from the bread. But today, I couldn't help it. I had to have the meat pie. The chicken, the carrots. I know carrots aren't great for the keto diet because of all the sugar, but I tried, fuck it. One bite and I saw Jesus." I'm here at the Vashon Center for the Arts. I'm standing in front of the new building. Nearby is the older, smaller performing arts center that's still there, still in use. I think now they call it, if I remember right, it's the Blue Heron. But a few years ago, the committee decided they wanted to have a bigger space, and so they built this new structure. It's gorgeous, as you can see. It's wood and glass all throughout. I haven't even been inside yet. I moved away before this was ever built, but since I've been back, I've seen it a number of times. I've just never gotten here until now. But this is appropriate for Memorial Day weekend. They've got a remembrance project going on, and this is the gallery where they're showing black and people of color who have been killed, or I guess murdered is probably the better word, died from police violence. Each picture is a different person honoring their legacy. And we know this is just the tip of the iceberg. If we were to go back for any length of time, we would have to add so many more names and faces to this wall. But I'm glad that they're doing that. I think it's important to recognize and honor those who've died from police violence, because we have to put a stop to it. Yeah, thanks. Oysters, fresh off the grill with a little bit of butter, garlic, Johnny's seasoning, with the beach, sun. Heaven.
We've been talking about YouTube and, you know, opening our lives up to the public. This is the right sign for public, right, Billy? You know, opening up our life to you, the viewers, we're both a little hesitant. We tend to be private people. So it's a little nerve-wracking. What is your response?
Yeah, I do have some hesitation about opening up and letting people in. I'm a really private person. And at the same time, I want this, I don't know, I guess business, this new YouTube enterprise thing to really take off. I want to work with sponsors, and I want to take care of myself and my wife and my family. This is a different type of job, a new era for me, and I want to take the talents that I have and use them in a different way to pay for my skills. I can do this to teach and advocate and work with companies and people that I believe in. And so, yeah, while I do have some hesitation, I think it's important to take those steps and see where they lead. And if at some point I get to a place or a time where I feel like I've shared too much, or people are wanting too much access, then I set boundaries and I pull back. I can do that. You know, they say haters gonna hate. People are always gonna have things to say. But bottom line for me is that we can agree to disagree. If somebody wants to get into an argument or a fight, make a point, I'll concede that point. I don't care. It's not worth the argument to me. Everybody has an opinion, and if you don't like what I'm saying, don't follow. If you're interested, let's have a conversation. Let's share our thoughts and ideas with one another, but most importantly, let's respect one another. I'm not interested in talking to you if you're not going to be respectful. So for me, it comes down to, if you want to follow me, I'm not requiring that you agree with everything I say or do. I'm just opening a window into my life where I can share my thoughts, feelings, things I'm doing. And so appreciate that. Take it for what it is. And if you're not interested, have a good life. Bottom line for me, it comes down to respect. Welcome to Billy That.